Previously on the Mask of Inanna.
We want you to maintain a lighthouse.
And you want an old guy with nothing better to do.
No, Mr. Allen. We want you. There's a speed bump that's hard to see without the light.
Are they trying to kill someone?
Just scare visitors.
Len, it has very rudimentary senses. It was curious about you and couldn't help itself.
Looking for something in particular?
The cellar.
What do you know about the cellar?
I assume there is one. So there is a cellar.
You know you've been to the entrance of the cellar. We've been watching you. It's here and in your dream state.
You mean the places with the wind chimes? The extra floors?
Yes.
The lily room?
What about the things in the lighthouse? With the feathers and claws?
We have to stop meeting like this.
Have you seen anyone else my age here? I don't know what it's like to live on the outside. I mean, I do. I can go out there and date people, but I can't go into any of their stores or eat their food.
I love limes, hard as liquor.
It's all the great machine out there.
The great machine.
Mass production.
It itches terrible. And the worms.
And Inanna only helps us if we don't mix with it.
More protection. More protection.
If I want something, I have to buy it from a local computer shop, or importer, or a farmer's market.
I'm at the island's grocer's. Can I pick you up anything? We make it all ourselves.
Don't get me wrong. It can be really worth it. We help Inanna. She helps us.
Inanna won't heal the sick, part the waves, or make your dead father a Lazarus.
People who want to be writers don't get writer's block.
I shot better than they did. I never slept on my watch.
When I'm sewing, it's like incredible. I could make a living with it. Everyone makes their living off something around here.
I'm a bookseller. I specialize in camp culture. I sell mostly to coffee houses and internet cafes.
It's just a royal pain to find people who get it, you know?
I know. It sounds like an old person's dream and a kid's nightmare.
The Mask of Inanna.
Hold up, Don.
Yeah?
Are you hurt?
I'll be fine. What's going on?
I don't know. It started acting funny a few hours ago. It usually calms down faster than this.
It's tearing up my car!
I can't stop it. I tried talking to it. I fed it. I drew it some pictures. I even started praying for it.
I can call the Tier 4 office and get a nuke.
We want to calm it down. Take my car home. I'll have the tunnel cordoned off until we know what's happening.
An attack?
No, not if someone's trying to get on the island. It's mad about something, and it won't tell me what.
My laptop's in the car. if you can get it, I'll salvage what I can.
Fine. Go. Have Scotty look after you.
Oh, thanks. I should be fine, though.
If it's not calm by morning, we'll warn the usual people, and we'll call an emergency committee. Go!
Mr. Allen? Mr. Allen?
I'm in here. What's wrong?
You didn't answer your phone.
I let the voicemail take it.
You don't have voicemail.
Huh. That's why no one leaves any messages.
You can't go in the tunnel.
I wasn't planning to.
No one can. The speed bump's gone crazy. It trashed my dad's car. It won't let anyone get near it.
Well, what's happened?
They don't know.
It might be those mammons.
No, they would have been spotted. It was being weird last night, but it should have calmed down by now.
So this is bad?
Very bad.
Very, very bad.
The church might be exposed.
Well, how are you holding up?
What do you mean?
Well, since the mammons broke in here, I know it's been a few days.
Oh, okay, I guess. I'm busy.
Good, good.
You should see the tunnel. They've blocked it off with construction signs and everything.
How worried should I be?
They're trying not to make a big deal out of it, so I'm not sure.
So you don't know?
Nope.
What will your people do if it doesn't calm down?
I have an idea that might work. I don't know. Can I borrow the lighthouse balcony?
What are you going to do there?
Just some reading.
Oh, you don't have to ask for that.
Thanks. I might go out to catch the ferry later.
Well, I didn't know the island had one.
It doesn't come often.
And the speed bump won't attack it?
The speed bump won't leave the tunnel. Mr. Lewis said he's tried everything. He faked some mammoths outside the tunnel, and it still won't go after them.
Oh, could you let Orson and Mr. Obler out? I'm sorting through the old maritime records.
Sure.
They've been in and out all yesterday.
I'm grabbing something from the shed. Then I'll be upstairs. If there's a phone call...
I'll get it.
Great. See you.
Where was I? Right. August 1870. Schooner. Pleasant day. Pleasure craft. God, these men must have been bored. Ugh, no wonder they locked these things up. What's happening? Am I awake? Scotty!
Wide, mouth wide, scrumple history!
I know you.
She's going to be very mad, you know. The warrior says she's the shoe that crushes its owner's foot. That's you.
Does he?
You must know. So know much. Why?
I don't follow you.
Your enemies are wandering, but see? They have returned.
Who's my enemy? Bob?
Not Bob. Much, much worse. Want her to be mad.
Who?
The book tells half the story. The whole you must see. Before they can stop me.
Stop me from seeing what?
Face him and know. Know as others can't.
Know what? Why is it getting dark in here? A straight answer would be nice. Not you. Do we have to do this again? I don't want to be here any more than you. Get back! Back!
Ah! Oh, pardon me. My humblest apologies, sir. Allow me to help you up.
Thank you. What's happening? Where? Where is this?
Forgive me. You must have hit your head, sir. Here, have a nip of this. Don't let the patients know.
Oh, thank you. Patients?
This is St. Mary's Hospital for the Poor. Yonkers, not the one they have upstate. Are you looking for someone?
No. Are you the doctor?
They call me that here, but I'm still a few years from the title. But someday... Oh, Mrs. Cavendish, don't unwrap that. I've warned you.
It itches terrible. And the worms.
It'll weep a month longer if you keep at it as you are. Ask your son to bring a few bottles the next time he's over. I'll warn the matron to overlook them.
Oh, bless you, sir.
You'll excuse me. Sir, are you all right?
I'm sorry. I've just never seen injuries like these.
You're from uptown? You'll grow accustomed to it. Mrs. Cavendish's severed arm is hardly the worst. It's her own fault for being here, her foreman says. We get a dozen of them every month from the factories.
Mr. Adams.
Ah, Mr. Carney. You had no trouble finding your way.
A little. And I'd appreciate your company when I leave the neighborhood.
You'll have it. You'll pardon me a minute, Mr...
Allen.
A pleasure, Mr. Allen, a pleasure. Now, Mr. Carney, your man's in the fourth bed there, passed out.
Sweet Jesus.
I wouldn't get too close. Can you explain what a fine Pinkerton man like him would be doing in a hospital such as this? Seeing as how you wish to join the force yourself, sir.
I can't.
He's in bad shape. He won't last long here with that gut wound. He's only been on the force 3 years.
They said he had the best of care when I asked them.
They must like you, eh? To lie to you? Come on. There's plenty of private jobs for a trusted, sensible hired man who rarely tires. With the attention of a hawk and the speed of a jackal, you'll get farther than any of these poor souls in the machine. The Blessed Maiden will see to that.
Excuse me? Sir, I don't mean to interrupt. Are you speaking of Inanna?
Keep your voice lower, sir. What do you know of her?
She has a very resilient church.
That she does. I haven't seen you at any meetings, though.
I've heard bits and rumors through friends. I'm an entertainer, a teller of stories.
Oh, an entertainer. You should have said why you came today. You're here for the newcomer service?
Yes.
You'll need someone to vouch for you. But you seem an honest sort. Oh, where are my manners? This gentleman is also here for the newcomer service.
Alexis Carney, Mr. Allen. Good to meet you.
How do you do?
Perhaps we should be going. Follow me. It's not far. A moment. I always stopped for a bite. Excuse me, ma'am. I'll have 3 of the limes. I love limes. Hard as liquor.
I'm sure. Ah, a newspaper. August 10th, 1870.
That's yesterday's.
Heavens. I forgot to warn the matron. Wait here.
Are you expecting something in the paper?
Well, that's where the news is, isn't it?
Not all of it, though.
Is there something I should know?
Who sent you here?
Mr. David Lewis, I think.
I've never heard of him.
He's a friend of the Inanna folk.
Ah. What's he told you?
That it's a church of passionate people who do passionate things, like selling curios to restaurants or seamstressing. I know a girl who can make dresses like you've never seen.
I'm sure. And you hope to entertain the masses with your wit.
That's right. As you hope to be a security man, correct?
Yes. They may have given you a false impression of what to expect.
I don't believe so.
Mr. Adams' passion is his medicine. But he plies his trade with the unwed mothers of the uptown families to pay for the work he does here.
If you don't believe in Inanna, why are you here?
To see if Adams is the rule or the exception.
Well, we'll see tonight.
You are certain to go?
Oh, definitely.
Mr. Adams is too kind to admit it, but the service should be standing room only tonight. Perhaps another night.
I have nothing else planned tonight.
Really, I insist. You will have plenty of other opportunities.
I rather doubt it.
That's sorted out. Are you ready?
I am.
I am.
Excellent. Gentlemen, this way. Sorry about the pat-down, gentlemen. And the questioning on your part, Mr. Allen.
I understand.
I wasn't worried.
From Mr. Carney's description, I thought there'd be more people tonight.
They are coming. Well, welcome to the Temple of Inanna, built by our architects to ancient plans found in Sumeria herself, hidden, as you have seen, in a common warehouse on the docks. See on the altar before us the sealed reliquary. Our founder has placed within it our most sacred artifact, which she acquired from the Holy Lands, the Mask of Inanna. It was revealed through visions from Inanna herself.
Will we see it during the service?
Not tonight, I'm afraid. Our founder should be arriving soon. You can take up the matter with her. Ah, Myrtle.
Hot tea for you, sirs.
Thank you.
A better brew you won't find, and yet its leaves are from the same shop you go to, sirs.
Thank you. Oh, my.
Never had the like.
And you won't, sirs, unless you've slaved over a kettle as I have.
I'm sure. What will we be expected to do at the service tonight?
Listen only. Now that we're gathered, friends, welcome, one and all. You've been drawn to Inanna after witnessing flagrant injustice or fearing the dark road our country is set on. This civil war may be at an end, but the carnage it's wrought will be with us always, and it's led to the rise of the great machine.
He has that right.
I suppose so.
I want to dispel any illusions you might have about the church. Inanna won't heal the sick, part the waves, or make your dead father a Lazarus. You want miracles? The Holy Father has them down the street. Oh, but if you've passion in your belly, the Blessed Maiden will stoke it, squeeze the bellows, and keep your pocket full of change. You won't be rich through her, but you'll be rich in spirit and satisfied with life in a way few men are. Billy here survived Appomattox.
By the grace of Inanna, she kept my eyes wide and my feet nimble. The South only took my arm instead of my heart.
The goddess has foreseen the rise of the great machine and us as its cogs. What is it? Ironwork, line work, work for a man up top who wants to see your eyes dulled and busy, a yoke around your neck and a gallows beneath your feet, and an executioner who says the only alternative is the poorhouse or the wasteland. To hell with the great machine!
To hell!
The only things we take from the factories are soot, consumption, and a pittance, and the other so-called faiths are its snares. Fair to the papists and their empty promises, and fair to the mammons and their wizard ways. You have to bet half their circle to join them anyhow. Men and women both. Here, all are welcome. When you show the spark of inner power, Inanna joyfully brings you to the inner fold. Do you see this candle beside me? Cold and unlit. Touch that, will you? You see? And now, watch. The flame appears without a touch, and yet the wick is still as cold as ice now. Feel that, sir. A second ago, you saw it unlit.
I did.
But fire you see now. Fire that is not fire. Illusions. That is also what Inanna offers.
But why does she give so much and ask for so little?
To nurture the passions of the world, sir. Your dedication is sacrifice enough. She wants us to experience our own raptures, our own torments, which she experiences through us. She knows the world is changing to dull the core of men. Can you imagine being goddess of such a desolate place?
Excuse me. Your soldier friend, Billy, I have a question for him. Isn't the army also a great machine?
But it serves the country, sir. Inanna herself is a goddess of war. Art and war. She sees no differences. It is the struggle that matters to her.
And the government serves the people, not the barons. Entirely different.
That should be our guest now. Unbar the doors, please. Friends, I give to you our illustrious founder, back from her latest excursion to the east. We are only too glad to have her with us. Everyone, run! Run for your lives!
We're here for the mask.
Go, everyone!
Wild maidens, foreigners, and ghouls, the lot of you!
Oh! You son of a bitch! You knew the whole time! You tried to keep me from coming!
Fella, as thick as you deserve to die. For Mammon!
Fire! Someone get water!
Myrtle, Billy, hold them back! I have the mask. Give me time!
time. We have 5 times your numbers. Most of them are gang members who believe they're attacking their rivals. Give me the mask, or I make them believe you're their most hated foe. You won't have it. Tear it from him. We have it. Run before the temple falls.
Adams, can you stand? I've got to get you out. Oh, come on! Your eyes are open, you're breathing, answer me! Say something! We're running out of air! Adams, I don't think I can drag you out of here! Damn it!
It's fine.
Oh, thank God! I thought you were in shock! We have to get out!
Look at the fire around here. There is no way out. The entrance and the vestry are blocked. I'm sorry, Mr. Allen.
How can you be so calm?
I made certain they stole the illusion of the mask, not the true mask. While you thought me still, I walked out from my body. I went deep underground and saw the true mask. It is safe. They do not suspect anything.
I can't breathe.
Nor can I. But I did well. I die happy. Goodbye, Mr. Allen. Goodbye.
Can you see me? Mr. Allen, look at me.
Was I under?
Yeah, and you were screaming about being on fire.
I was. Oh, it was one of those visions.
What happened?
I was in 1870 at one of your churches. This man Adams brought me there. Then the Mammons raided it. They burned it down. Oh, I better get that.
I'll get you a towel.
Hello?
Glenn, did Scotty get a hold of you?
She told me about your troubles with the speed bump.
I've never seen it this stubborn. We're trying to draw it into a tractor trailer, but it won't budge.
Have you tried shooting it?
We could drop a nuke on it, but I doubt that would scratch it. We're out of ideas. The bump responded to you before. Can you come here and give us a hand?
I'd rather not.
I didn't want to ask you either, but we need a fresh mind on this. And if we don't clear the tunnel by tonight, the other islanders are going to cause trouble. The town's selectmen especially, and they like having a tunnel that keeps the tourists out. If the media or more police come here, I don't think we can handle them. We may have to abandon the island in a few days.
For crying out loud. All right. I'll have Scotty drive me over.
Thank you, Len.
He's not having any luck.
Hardly.
Towel?
Thank you. We're going to the tunnel. Mr. Lewis wants me to help out.
Wow. Is this because the bump attacked you?
Probably. Perhaps it's looking for me.
Then I should give you an extra shot before we go.
What are you talking about?
Cinnamon B. It's part spirit, so it probably makes you look different than us to the speed bump.
Why can't Mr. Lewis use someone himself to lure the bump out?
Because it's addictive. And the only other people who use it are Wall Street traders who need something better than coke.
I see your point. You have some of it here?
Yeah. No peeking.
Hold on a minute. Do you know how to do injections?
Yes. I've injected you before.
When? Did you put it in me before?
All set.
What do you mean?
I just gave it to you.
Well, I didn't feel anything.
You didn't see it either. Don't worry. I can't do that to anyone but you.
Do what?
We should move while it's still fresh.
You're an odd one.
Thanks.
I doubt I can help you, though.
It's okay. I'm working on a backup plan.
Why don't we go with that first?
It's not ready yet. I should talk to Mr. Lewis about it.
You can tell me.
Later. Maybe.
Well then. Lead onward. I thought you said the speed bump was causing trouble.
It is.
Well, I don't see anyone in there.
Ms. McAllister put a veil up. It's very World of Darkness.
Oh my goodness!
It keeps the locals from seeing in.
Good, you made it.
Behold our hubris. Smashing cars and tearing up the road.
It's been acting up like this all day.
And all last night.
It's a deaf, blind, rabid dog in there.
With Alzheimer's.
Hush.
Sorry. I gave Mr. Allen an extra shot before we left.
Good thinking. Len, take this bag.
What's in it?
Food for the speed bump. There.
Valentine's Day cards?
Kids' Valentines. I collect them from around the school's recycle bins in February and save them all year round.
It eats these?
Like candy. Better than its old favorite.
Dare I ask how you found out that it likes these?
Of course. It was back when I was in grade school. We had to give cards to everyone on Valentine's Day. Even to kids no one liked.
Like you.
Yes. And after school, I used to go and play with Speed Bump before I went home.
Uh-huh.
We all wondered where he'd gotten to.
It was my only friend. Anyhow, I brought my pity Valentines with me, and I was just tossing them into the water. And I noticed that the Speed Bump started to fetch them and eat them.
It eats the card's emotional resonance. It likes anything that reeks of trauma.
It prefers pity and abandonment, but yes, it does eat. Only spiritual food, though, since it's a spiritual creature with a very primitive body. Len, could you scatter the cards in there?
You're kidding me.
Just to see how it reacts. I have a van ready to pull you out if there's any trouble.
What sort of reaction are you looking for?
If it barrels at you at full speed, you can lead it into the tractor trailer.
We have it all planned out. You'll be safe.
I have your word.
The van will back down, and they'll grab you and bolt. They already did it for me.
It's true. We have very professional people.
Fine. Don't let me down.
Any changes?
Nope. Wait, it's coming towards him.
Say when they should retrieve Alan.
Hang on. It stopped.
For crying out loud.
Give it some time. It's moving again.
Tell me when.
Wait. Never mind.
We have your back, Len.
I grew up watching horror movies. That thing isn't getting anywhere near me. Did it do what you wanted?
No. Damn it.
It's eating some of the cards. No, they're only sticking to it.
Well, didn't you have a backup plan, Scotty?
Yeah, kinda. I'm still working on the details.
What is it?
It's... Can I tell you in private?
Fine. Come with me. We'll discuss it with your dad.
David finally understands what I've been telling him. We can't command the spiritual any more than a wild lion, even if it is raised with us.
Do you have any ideas on how to get rid of it?
I can jingle its car keys to let it know it's overstayed its welcome. I don't think it's gonna listen, though.
No, probably not.
Worst case, we seal it in. And then try to explain to the state where our tunnel went.
Change or die.
Yep. I can tell there's been a bad presence here. It's not controlling the bump, but it did something. Now the bump's like this.
Is there any way to track it, or...?
No, it popped in and out. So how are you making out?
All right. My legs are sore. I walked across the island yesterday.
The radio show is going very well. I'm really looking forward to the next. Everyone's listening, even some of the non-believers.
Oh, thank you.
So, do you have any questions for me?
Questions?
About the radio show and the speed bump?
I suppose.
Did you get the diary I left for you?
You left me a pile of history books.
No, the diary. I left it on your doorstep a couple nights ago.
I can't say that I've seen it.
Oh, for the love of Jasmine! Are you sure?
Yes. No diary. No other books either. The book tells half the story. Of course. Scotty! Hey! Hey, Scotty!
What?
Miss McAllister said she left a diary for me on my doorstep.
Yeah?
I know that look. Where is it?
I put it in your tool shed.
Scotty!
It's under some rags in the corner. I was going to give it to you when I was done.
This wouldn't be why the speed bump's gone feral, is it?
No. Maybe. I don't know. I have to run. Dad and I are leaving for the ferry now.
What are you up to?
It's not that dangerous. Dad's taking care of the details. I have to go. Bye.
Not that dangerous. Of course not. Jesse, I need someone to drop me off at home. Goodbye, Jesse. I'll give that girl an earful when she gets back. It was right where she said it was. A few paw prints. At least she wrapped it up in cloth. And she stuck colorful tags on all the relevant pages. This journal belongs to Private Matthew Lerner, 1945. My Matt Lerner, who worked on my show. I suppose they would still have his things. He must have written this after the war. Let's see here. Since the war ended, though, I wish I could be a gosh darn Rip Van Winkle. Oh, I'd better sit down for this.